Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Well, another week of politics and another week of drama. The Green Party under the pump after the resignation of co-leader Matiria Tude and a disastrous midweek poll which saw them drop to 8%. Joining me now to discuss the week's events are Greens Pacific candidates Leilani Tamu and Teanau Tuiono. Thank you both for coming in.
Kia ora.
Teanau, I want to start with you. The week, it hasn't been the best for the Greens. What's the feeling in the camp at the moment?
Oh, you know, it's been a bit of a roller coaster ride. I feel like I'm at Rambo's End. But, you know, the political climate has changed over the last 2 weeks. We are the party that, which is used to dealing with climate change issues. We are weathering the storm.
And what, I mean, with Matiria, have you spoken to her this week? How's she feeling? How's she taking this whole news?
You know, it's she's taken time out with her family, as you can imagine. We still stand for the ideas that she has opened up, really, in the country. So we're looking forward to continuing that struggle, continuing on putting poverty on the nation's agenda.
And Leilani, the polls that came out this week weren't the best for the Greens either. Do you think the Green Party can recover from this in time for the election?
Absolutely. I mean, one of the things I always, I guess, say about polls is that it depends who they polled. and I'm certainly one of those New Zealanders who's never had that phone call. And I'd say for a lot of our Pasifika, actually, they aren't often polled either. So, you know, I think these polls often are a reflection of the status quo. And I think there's a real mood for change in this country, particularly for those who've been left behind for far too long. And many of them are from our community.
So how do you think you can engage with those people that you've talked about who have, aren't engaging with politics? Do you think that these polls maybe might not be a particularly true reflection of the results next month? Do you think there might be a resurgence in Green voters if they can pick up that the forgotten people?
Absolutely. I mean, our voters are there. There's no doubt about it. And both Teanau and I are really, we know that because, A, I mean, how do we think we're going to get them? Firstly, we're standing, and that's huge. Just in terms of our own communities, the fact that the Greens have two of us in their top 20 in electable positions is huge. Secondly, we're out campaigning day and night. We've both given up paid work for the next 42 days to essentially knock on as many doors as we can, get to the markets, get to where the people are.
Elena, Teanau, what's your feeling? Do you think that the Green Party can recover this? Are you confident that you can get back into double digits from?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, this has happened to us before, and you know, we'll see those polls bounce up and down. But you know, the poll that counts the most is the one on September the 23rd. We're out there talking with people, and these people, as Leilani was saying, they don't have landlines. A lot of them, just sort of acknowledging our MP, Pasifika spokesperson Marama Davidson, who was actually outside the Wynn's office yesterday talking to folks. I mean, from our perspective, we're getting a lot of support for the ideas that we're putting out there in the community.
Where do you see those votes coming from? Because you're down to 8%, but to get back in those double digits, do you see them coming off Labor, National, New Zealand First? Where do you see those votes coming in?
I don't see votes as lollies down the dairy, where people have specific rights to particular votes. It's really all about sort of being able to get your message out there, put them in front of people and say, hey, look, this is what we're about, this is what we want to do. Come and have a listen.
And in terms of Labor Greens, Leilani, what's the biggest difference you see? Because traditionally Pacific people tend to vote Labor, and you've got the Greens Party now, you've got two Pacific candidates in there. What do you think is the main difference if you're trying to sell it to people who are voting Labor or not voting Green? What would you say to them?
So number one, I think the difference for our Pasifika people is that you've got Teanau and I at the table now, and we both have international experience. Teanau was a climate change negotiator, I was a diplomat. We actually represent a new generation of Pasifika candidates who have worked hard, and we bring something different to Parliament. So I think that's the first thing. The second thing is that I think in terms of our policies, I think our policies actually reflect the reality of Pasifika people today, and that we don't take for granted that affordability is $600,000-$700,000 for a house. We have progressive home ownership policies, for example, which say actually rent to buy. We will help you get in through paying rent, and that for me is a key difference.
Right. Okay, there's the sales pitch there for the Greens Party. We'll be continuing this discussion right after our show. Thank you both for coming on. We really appreciate it. But until then, back to you, Marama and JP.
Thank you.
Malo Pito, thank you so much.